हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर मंगेश जोशी, वर्किंग एज ए असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन सटाना कॉलेज। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट कन्फर्मेशंस ऑफ साइक्लोहेक्सेन। बिफोर गोइंग इन टू द डिटेल्स, विल सी सम हिस्टोरिकल बैकग्राउंड ऑफ साइक्लोहेक्सेन। इन लास्ट वीडियो वी सॉ दैट बेयर्स एंगल स्ट्रेन। In 1885, Baer put this theory. He considered that all cycloalkanes are planar. So, he considered that all cycloalkanes are strain compounds. Only cyclopentane is more stable ring as it contains a less angle strain. After that, 1890, Sachet suggested that cyclohexane is a non-planar molecule and exists in two conformations that are free from angle strain: chair conformation as well as boat conformation. So these are the chair conformations and boat conformation. But nobody believes on this Sachet, because at that time Baer's angle strain was very popular, and Sachet is unable to separate out chair form and boat form. So again Baer's theory is continued. In 1918, Moore suggested that possibility of existence of chair and boat conformations which are readily undergo conversion by single bond rotation. He used the concept of chair and boat form to study decalin system and predicted that decalin should have two isomers, cis and trans decalin. After that, in 1925, Haeckel actually separated the two isomers of decalin and gave strong support to existence of chair and boat conformation of cyclohexane. Since then, study of the conformations of cyclohexane is called as Sachet-Moore theory. Again, we will learn some factors affecting the stability of conformations. There are three main factors which affect the stability of conformations of the cyclohexane. First one is angle strain, second is torsional strain, and third one is dipole-dipole interaction. We'll learn one by one. So first one is angle strain. So any deviation from normal band angle, that is 109.5, is called as angle strain. As angle strain increases, stability of the molecule decreases. This is the structure of cyclopropane. See here, in cyclopropane, angle strain is equal to 109.5, that is normal sp3 bond angle, minus 60, that is internal bond angle, is equal to 49.5. That is the maximum angle strain in case of cycloalkanes. So because of this deformation of angle, there is a weak overlap in between pi pi orbitals. That's why this weak bond becomes more weak. See here, these are the staggered conformations of ethane, and this one is the eclipsed conformation of ethane. These staggered conformations, all sigma bonds are maximum away from each other, as well as all hydrogens are maximum away from each other. So there is no relative strain. So this staggered conformation is more stable. While in case of this eclipsed conformations, these two sigma bonds are parallel to each other, these two sigma bonds are parallel to each other, these sigma bonds are parallel to each other. So these bonds are parallel, their bonding electrons are also near to each other, so there will be electronic-electronic repulsion that causes a strain, and that gives instability to this conformation, that is called as torsional strain. So what is meant by torsional strain? So any deviation from the staggered conformation causes a torsional strain in a molecule, due to which internal energy of the molecule increases and stability conformation decreases. So this staggered conformation is very stable conformation, as these bonds are maximum away from each other, as well as atoms are maximum away from each other. So any change in this dihedral angle causes these two atoms closer to each other, as well as these two bonds are closer to each other, that increases the internal energy and molecule becomes unstable. Third factor is dipole-dipole interaction. It is the interaction of one positive end of the polar molecule for the negative end of the another molecule, for example H2 and HF. Here these are the HF molecules. So positive end of one molecule is attracted towards the negative end of the another molecule. So this is called as weak electrostatic bond. If one end is hydrogen, that bond is called as hydrogen bond. We'll see now what are the chair and board conformations of cyclohexane. In 1890, Sasse suggested that cyclohexane could exist in two non-planar structures, which will be free from angle strain. One is a chair form and other is a board form. See, these are the structures. First two are the chair forms and second two are the board forms. All are cyclohexane, just their conformation is different. One is chair, one is board. This looks like a chair. These four carbons, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 6 and carbon number 4, these four carbons are in a plane, while carbon number 1 is above the plane, carbon number 4 is below the plane. That's why this is called as chair conformation. While in this case, carbon number 2, 3 and carbon number 6 and 5, these four carbons are in one plane, while both carbon number 1 and carbon number 2 are above the plane or below the plane. So this looks like a boat, that's why this conformation is called as boat conformation. Now see here, this is the chair conformation. If we deform these structures, and this cyclohexane is flexible, so we rotate this carbon atom downside. So carbon number 4 is below the plane. If this considered carbon number 2, carbon number 3 and carbon number 6, carbon number 5, if these four carbons are in a plane, so carbon number 1 is above the plane, carbon number 4 is below the plane. If you rotate this sigma bonds and bring this carbon number 1 below the plane, then now in this structure carbon number 1 as well as carbon number 4 are below the plane. So this looks like a boat. So there is a continuous exchange in between chair form as well as board form. Again, this board form, carbon number 1, if you bring it upside, so you will get another form of the chair. Again, if you brought this carbon number 1 above the plane, again you will get another conformation of boat structure. All these chair and boat and chair conformations are interconverted. Now we'll see axial and equatorial bonds in cyclohexane. This is structure of cyclohexane. Cyclohexane has molecular formula C6H12. Cyclohexane contains 12 hydrogen, but all are not same. There are two types of hydrogen in a cyclohexane: axial hydrogen as well as equatorial hydrogen. Axial hydrogens, the hydrogens or bonds which are perpendicular to the average plane of the molecule are called as axial hydrogen. This is the chair conformation and this is the average plane of the molecule. So to this one, these bonds are perpendicular to the average plane of the molecule. These bonds are called as axial bonds. Second type is equatorial hydrogens. So hydrogens are bonds which are projecting outward and are average plane of the molecule are called as equatorial hydrogens. So these hydrogens are going outward from the ring and in a average plane of the molecule. These bonds or these hydrogens are called as equatorial hydrogens. Now we will see axial and equatorial bonds in cyclohexane. For identification, I give color red and blue hydrogen. So as we know that all 12 hydrogens of cyclohexanes are not same. This is the chair form of cyclohexane. Carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, and these are the 12 hydrogens. 6 hydrogens are red and 6 hydrogens are blue. First we will see the axial hydrogens. So I give color to the axial hydrogens, a red color. See, there are 6 axial bonds, 6 axial hydrogens, one on each carbon. One on each carbon, those are parallel lines to the each other, alternate up and down directions. Here carbon number 1 is down, carbon number 2 is अप, कार्बन नंबर 3 इज डाउन, कार्बन नंबर 4 इज अप, अगेन कार्बन नंबर 5 इज डाउन, कार्बन नंबर 6 इज अप. दीज आर द परपेंडिकुलर लाइन्स टू द एवरेज प्लेन ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल्स. दिस थ्री बॉन्ड्स आर ऑल्सो परपेंडिकुलर टू दिस वन, दिस थ्री बॉन्ड्स आर ऑल्सो परपेंडिकुलर टू एवरेज प्लेन ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल. थ्री एक्सियल बॉन्ड्स आर अबव द प्लेन वाइल थ्री एक्सियल बॉन्ड्स आर below the plane. There is alternate up and down direction. Again, upward carbon has upward axial bond and downside carbon has downward axial bond. So there are total 6 axial bond. Now we'll see equatorial bond. Again, there are 6 equatorial bonds, one on each carbon. Alternate up and down. See here, up hydrogen, down hydrogen, up hydrogen, down hydrogen, up hydrogen, down hydrogen. These blue hydrogens are equatorial hydrogens. For differentiation, I give this different color. Red are axial and blue are equatorial. These are again straight lines going outward from the ring. If this is the cyclohexane chair from ring, these equatorial bonds are going outward from the ring. The differentiation from axial and equatorial: up carbon has up axial and down equatorial, while down carbon has down axial and up equatorial. Each carbon has one axial bond and one equatorial bond. See here, each carbon, carbon number 1, one equatorial, one axial. Again, each equatorial bond is parallel to the alternate ring bond. See here, this purple bond, by leaving this bond, this is parallel to this purple bond. So alternate bonds are parallel. See here, one and this is bond is parallel. This bond and this bond is parallel. Similarly here also, this bond and this bonds are parallel. See, this pink color bonds are parallel to each other, purple color bonds are parallel to each other, and green bonds are parallel to each other. Now you see ring flipping. What is a ring flipping? This is the one chair form, carbon number 1 and carbon number 4. Carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, carbon number 6 and carbon number 5. So carbon number 2, 3, 5 and 6 are in one plane. Carbon number 4 is below the plane while carbon number 1 is above the plane. This is one chair form. If we ring flip means when one chair form is converted into another chair, it is known as ring flipping. After ring flip, axial bonds become equatorial and equatorial bonds become axial. See here, for ring flipping, one of the carbon which is above the plane, I bring it downside, while downside carbon below the plane, that bring it up. So carbon number 1 going below to the plane, while carbon number 4 is going above to the plane. Now see here, this black hydrogens, previously they were axial hydrogens, now those becomes equatorial hydrogens. While these red hydrogens, which are equatorial bonds or equatorial hydrogens, becomes axial hydrogens. So in this case, in ring flipping, axial bonds are converted to the equatorial, while equatorial bonds are converted to the axial. But remember, the bonds which are above the plane or up remains up. See here, at this carbon number 1, this axial hydrogen is above the plane. Now that axial is converted to the equatorial. See here, carbon number 1, this equatorial hydrogen is above the plane. So axial becomes equatorial and equatorial becomes axial. But beta always beta bonds, means upside bonds are become upside bonds, while downside bonds becomes always becomes downside bonds. So ring flipping is very easy concept, that is just conversion of one form to another form, because these rings are flexible. Now let's see the boat conformation of cyclohexane in more details. So this shape is looks like a boat. That's why this conformation is called as boat conformation. As we know that this is the cyclohexane, so number of carbons are 6. While this is sp3 hybridized, so all are single bond, so it contains 12 hydrogens, and normal bond angle is 109.3 degrees. In the boat conformations, there are 4 types of hydrogens. So we'll see one by one. First one is flagpole hydrogens. So this carbon number 1 and carbon number 4 are above the plane, so it has 2 hydrogens. These hydrogens looks like a flagpole, so that's why these are called as flagpole hydrogens. Those are coming close to each other, so the distance between them is just 1.8 angstrom in it. As we know that the radius of this hydrogen atoms is 2.25 angstrom in it, so there is no enough space to occupy this hydrogen. Those hydrogens are called as flagpole hydrogens. On the same carbon where flagpole hydrogens are there, another 2 types of hydrogens are there. Those are called as bowsprit hydrogens. So this looks like a bowsprit hydrogen. There are 4 quasi-axial hydrogens. So this red hydrogens are axial hydrogens. Those are called as quasi-axial hydrogens, which are perpendicular to the average plane of the molecule. And fourth is quasi-equatorial hydrogens. So these brown hydrogens, those are called as quasi-equatorial hydrogens. Those are going away from the ring, this boat conformation. So there are 4 types of hydrogens: flagpole hydrogens, bowsprit hydrogens, quasi-axial hydrogens, and quasi-equatorial hydrogens. So these are the 4 types of hydrogens present to the molecule. Now we'll see the stability of chair and boat conformation of cyclohexane. This is the chair form of the cyclohexane. If you look this molecule from one side along carbon number 3 and carbon number 4, so this conformation, it looks like a Newman position formula. So carbon number 3 and carbon number 5 are towards the observer. If you are the observer, carbon number 5 and carbon number 3, while carbon number 2 and carbon number 6 are the rear carbons. So this is the carbon number 6 and carbon number 2. This is in the position formula. Carbon number 2 and carbon number 6 are away from the observer. That's why this look can be written into the circle, periphery of the circle. Carbon number 2 and carbon number 6 attaches to the carbon number 1, which is above the plane. See, the carbon number 6 and carbon number 2 are attached to the carbon number 1, which is above the plane. And carbon number 3 and carbon number 5 are attached to the carbon number 4, which is below the plane. So carbon number 5 and carbon number 3 attached to carbon number 4, which is below the plane. Now this Newman position formula is a staggered formula where all hydrogens are maximum away from each other. Dihedral angle is 60. So as this all bonds, all atoms are maximum away from each other, there is a less steric hindrance, less torsional strain. Now we'll see the boat. This is the boat conformations. These are the flagpole hydrogens. These are quasi-axial hydrogens, quasi-equatorial hydrogens, and this is the bowsprit hydrogens. Now we'll look like molecule from this one side, from the carbon number 3 and carbon number 4. So we'll see this molecule are written into the Newman position formula. So this carbon number 3 and carbon number near to the observer, so these are the points. While this carbon number 2 and carbon number 6 away from the observer, so these are the periphery of the circle. Now see here, this carbon number 2 and carbon number 3 attached to carbon number 1, which is above the plane. So this carbon number 6 and carbon number 2 attached to the carbon number 1 above the plane. Similarly, carbon number 3 and carbon number 5 attached to carbon number 4, which is above the plane. So carbon number 3 and carbon number 5 attached to carbon number 4, which is above the plane. Now this Newman projection formula is a eclipsed form. So there are 4 pairs of hydrogens which are parallel. See, 1, 2, 3 and 4. As this bond becomes parallel, there is an increase in torsional strain. So torsional strain of the 4 pairs of hydrogens and flagpole hydrogens, as we know that the distance between these is 1.8 angstrom in it, while the radius of hydrogen is 2.25 angstrom in it. So there is no much space to occupy these two hydrogens. So there is lots of steric hindrance also. So that increases the potential energy of the molecule in the boat conformation. So boat conformation stability is decreased. Chair is more stable than boat. The energy barrier, the energy gap between this boat and chair is 7.1 kilocalorie per mole. Now we'll see twist or skew boat conformation. This is the boat form of cyclohexane. These are the two flagpole hydrogens. As we know that the distance between these two flagpole hydrogens is 1.8 angstrom unit. The radius is 2.25 angstrom unit, so there is no much space to occupy these two hydrogens. So what will happen? They will repel each other. So what will happen? One hydrogen is coming towards the observer while another hydrogen is going away from the observer to maximize the distance between two hydrogens. Now see here, because of this 2 and 4 direction of these two hydrogens, this boat form becomes deformed. Previously in boat form, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 6 and carbon number 5 were into the same plane. Now because of the deformation, the plane of this 4 carbon will lose, while this carbon number 4 and carbon number 1 going away from each other. To minimize the torsional strain in between these two flagpole hydrogens, so this plane will get twisted, that's why this structure is called as twisted or skew boat form. In twisted or skew boat form, less torsional strain as compared to the boat conformation. Flagpole hydrogens are away from each other. These flagpole hydrogens are away from each other. Carbon number 2, 3, 5 and 6. This 2, 3, 5 and 6 becomes non-planar. Energy difference between boat and skew boat is 1.6 kilocalorie per mole. Skew boat is more stable than the boat conformation as well. Next conformation is half chair conformation. As we know that this is the chair form, this is the boat form. In chair form as well as boat form, four carbons are in one plane. Carbon number 2, 3, 5 and 6. Carbon number 2, 3, 5 and 6 are in a plane. In half chair form, five carbons are in a plane. 1, 2, 3, 6 and 5. Four carbon is above the plane or below the plane. So this conformation is called as half chair conformation. This contains a high angle strain. So it has a maximum energy content than any other conformation, that is around 11 kilocalorie per mole. So this is the least stable conformations among all conformations. So stability of the cyclohexane, chair form is more stable than twist boat or skew form, then boat form, and half chair form is the least stable conformation. Now you see the energy profile diagram of the cyclohexane conformation. See here, x-axis, that is energies in kilocalorie per mole, and these are the conformations. So cyclohexane in a chair form are considered as the most stable conformations. Their relative potential energy is zero. Then half chair conformations are most unstable conformations as there is a high angle strain in these conformations. The energy barrier in between chair conformation and half chair conformations is almost 10 to 11 kilocalorie per mole. Then twist boat. Twist boat are most stable conformation than half chair and boat conformations, but less stable than chair form. Then these are the boat forms where carbon number 1, carbon number 4 both are above the plane, which are stable than half chair conformation but less stable than twist foot conformations. In summary, thermal energy associated with the molecule at room temperature is around 15 to 20 kilocalories per mole. Energy barrier in between chair form and half chair form is maximum, that is 11 kilocalories per mole. So all conformations are converted from one form to another form. Because there is a dynamic equilibrium, the energy barrier between them is maximum 11 kilocalories per mole, but thermal energy associated with the molecule at room temperature is around 15 to 20, which is quite more than the energy barrier between most stable to most unstable conformation of the molecule. That's why the separation between these conformation is not possible for us. So friends, up to now we saw the conformations of cyclohexane. In next video we see the conformations of substituted cyclohexanes, monosubstituted cyclohexanes as well as disubstituted cyclohexanes. Thank you for watching, friends. Thank you. Keep watching. Thank you so much.